We invite you to join us for the singing of the opening hymn, O Come All Ye Faithful, in the bulletin. We will be following the order of service and the liturgy as it's found inside your bulletin. We'll begin with the responsive part of our service. We begin our worship in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, that I will raise to David a branch of righteousness. This is his name by which he will be called, the Lord our righteousness. A king who shall reign and prosper and execute judgment and righteousness in the earth. In his days, Judah will be saved and Israel will dwell safely. Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son and shall call his name Emmanuel. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. We pray. Lord God, you sent your only begotten Son into the world to be the Savior of all people and gave him the name Jesus. Mercifully grant that we who worship in his name tonight here on earth may joyfully see him face to face in heaven. Through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, ever one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. We'll continue with the singing of the next hymn in your bulletin, the next two pages.
Eden, God promised, and I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel.
God promised to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, in you and in your seed, all the families of the earth shall be blessed.
Through the prophet Isaiah, God promised, therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign.
Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel.
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
There shall come forth a rod from the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots.
God promised by the prophet Jeremiah, behold, these days are coming, says the Lord, that I will raise to David a branch of righteousness, and a king shall reign and prosper, and execute judgment and righteousness in the earth. In his days, Judah will be saved, and Israel will dwell safely. Now this is by the name which we will call him, Lord our righteousness.
Thank you.
The second symbol, the Annunciation lily, or Fleur de Lis. We wish one another a Merry Christmas. Why? Actually, it is impossible for us to understand fully or to explain completely the true meaning of Christ's birth. The truth is that Jesus, the Lord of heaven and earth, became a human child born of the Virgin Mary. The Annunciation lily, or Fleur de Lis, is a symbol for the human birth of Jesus, the Son of Mary, and of his divinity and royalty as the Son of God.
In the Apostles' Creed, we confess our faith in Jesus our Savior by saying, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. This is the miracle of God's wondrous love, that Jesus, God's only Son, came to earth to be born of a human mother. Jesus, true God, became true man to suffer and die for the sins of all people. This miracle to be of God's wondrous love was told to Mary by God's own messenger from heaven. Now in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was David of the house of, whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. Now, having come in, the angel said to her, rejoice, highly favored one. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women.
But once she saw him, she was troubled at his saying and considered what manner of greeting this was. Then the angel said to her, do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and of his king, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end. Then Mary said to the angel, how can this be, since I do not know a man? And the angel answered and said to her, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you. Therefore also, that Holy One who is to be born will be called the Son of God.
Thank you.
Third symbol, the Nativity. The birth of the Savior is represented by the symbol of the Nativity.
The manger signifies Jesus' human nature. The circle enclosing the three rays signifies that Jesus is the Son of God. When God decided that it was right, the promised Savior was born. Although he was the King of Kings, he was not born in a palace, but in a stable. Although he was the Son of God, his cradle was a manger. On this special night, the children joined the choir of angels to proclaim the Savior's birth, as it is told in the Gospel of Luke. We join the children and the shepherds of Bethlehem in glorifying and praising God for all the things we, by faith, have heard and seen, as it is told to us in the Holy Bible.
And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria.
So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered.
And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you.
Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid.
Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. Before I bring good tidings of joy to all people.
For there is born to us this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths lying in a manger."
And suddenly there was with the angels a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men."
Thank you.
So it was when the angels have gone away from them into heaven that the shepherds said to one another, let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass that the Lord has made known to us.
And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe laying in the manger.
Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the thing which was told them concerning this child.
And all those who heard it marveled at the things the shepherds told to them.
Mary kept all those things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they have heard and seen as it was told them.
Symbol, the crown and scepter. A person's name seldom tells us anything more than nationality and whether the person is male or female. But the names of Jesus tell us many things about him. In the Bible, Jesus is called many names like Emmanuel, Redeemer, Lamb of God, Good Shepherd, and many more. Tonight, we worship him as the King of Kings, as the light of the world, and as Jesus Christ. Throughout the Bible, Jesus is spoken of as a king. The Apostle Paul wrote in his first letter to Timothy, chapter 6, that Jesus is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. The Apostle John wrote in the last book of the Bible, in Revelation chapter 17, that the Lamb, that is Jesus, will overcome them, for he is Lord of Lords and King of Kings. Christ the King is symbolized by the royal crown and scepter. We sing of the truth that Jesus is the King of Kings in many of our hymns.
Lift up your heads, ye mighty gates. Behold, the King of glory awaits. The King of Kings is drawing near. The Savior of the world is here.
Oh, bless the
land,
the city blessed, where Christ the ruler is confessed. Oh, happy hearts and happy homes, to whom this King in triumph comes.
Enter now, my waiting heart, glorious King and Lord most holy.
The fifth symbol, the light of the world. Another name of Jesus, the light of the world, is symbolized by a sphere for the world, with four rays of light reaching out to the four points of the compass. In the Gospel of John, chapter 8, Jesus says of himself, "I am the light of the world. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life."
Those who walk in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of the shadow of death, upon them a light has shone.
Jesus was the true light, which gives light to every man coming into the world.
Oh!
sixth symbol, IHC, the name Jesus. Before Jesus was born, God, through angels, told Mary and Joseph that they were to call her firstborn son Jesus. The symbol for Jesus is the first three letters of his name in Greek capital letters. They look like the English capital letters I, H, C. In Matthew, we hear the angel Gabriel's words to Joseph explaining the meaning of the name Jesus. And she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. The seventh symbol, XP, Cairo, the name Christ. In the Bible, the Savior's name Jesus is frequently combined with the title Christ, which is the Greek word for Messiah, or anointed one. The symbol for Christ is the first two capital letters of the Greek word Christ. These two Greek letters look like the English capital letters X and P, and are pronounced Chi-Ro.
Therefore, God also has highly exalted him, and given him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of those in heaven, and of those on earth, and of those under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
Please rise. We will join in the responsive prayer that's found in your bulletin. For the gift of Jesus, our Savior and Lord,
we praise our Father in heaven.
O Jesus, Son of God, our Savior,
we praise and bless your holy name.
O Christ, the promised Savior of the world,
we rejoice in this salvation.
O King of kings and Lord of lords,
we give thanks for your coming with humility and power.
O light of the world,
we proclaim your holy name to the world around us.
Blessed God and Father, we give you our thanks and praise for fulfilling your great promises by giving us the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ. In spirit, we stand in holy awe and reverence before the manger of the Christ child. Though we cannot fathom the mystery that God, the Son of God, should take on our human flesh to redeem us, yet by faith we bow in reverence and wonder. Dear Lord, as we gather to worship you and consider that you became a child in the person of Jesus Christ, grant us a sense of gratitude and joy so that life, hope, and faith may be renewed in each one of us. Grant that we will always find in this Christ child the way of salvation, the forgiveness of sins, the deliverance from every evil power, and the hope of life everlasting. We pray that the incarnate Savior may rule in the hearts of all people everywhere. Extend the gracious rule of the Prince of Peace to all the nations of the earth by faith in his name. Give growth in grace and knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ to all believers, so that we might abound in love, joy, and peace, and in faith in every good work. Help us, O God, to make known abroad the sayings which have been told us concerning this child, as did the shepherds of long ago. May we always join our voices with the angel chorus in singing your praises. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. All this we pray in the name of the Christ child, Jesus, our Lord of lords and King of kings. Amen. Receive with believing hearts the blessing of our triune God. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.
Amen.
You may be seated.